Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nasta'dih wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlilhu fala hadiya lahu. Wa nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu. Wa nashhadu anna sayyidana wa mawlana Muhammadan 'abdullah wa rasuluhu. صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر. وقال تبارك وتعالى: إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر. قال تعالى: وإذ قال إبراهيم رب اجعل هذا البلد آمنا واجنبني وبني أن نعبد الأصنام رب إنهن أضللن كثيرا من الناس فمن تبعني فإنه مني ومن عصاني فإنك غفور رحيم. وقال تعالى: وإذ بوأنا لإبراهيم البيت مكان وإذ بوأنا لإبراهيم مكان البيت ألا تشرك بي شيئا وطهر بيتي للطائفين والعاكف والقائمين والركع السجود وأذن في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجال وعلى كل ضامن يأتين من كل فج عميق ليشهدوا منافع لهم ويذكروا اسم الله في أيام معلومات على ما رزقهم من بهيمة الأنعام فكلوا منها وأطعموا البائس الفقير. وقال تعالى: لن ينال الله لحومها ولا دماؤها ولكن ينالها التقوى منكم كذلك سخرها لكم لتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. وقال النبي صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم: ما من يوم أكثر من أن يعتق الله فيه عبدا من النار من يوم عرفة وإنه ليدنو ثم يباهي بهم الملائكة فيقول ما أراد هؤلاء. وقال تعالى: خير الدعاء دعاء يوم عرفة. وكان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يصوم تسعة ذي الحجة. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: أكثر الدعاء صلى الله عليه وسلم لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. My dear brothers, Alhamdulillah, it is a great pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has given us a tawfiq to be in the month of Dhul-Hijjah. And we are in the, what date is it of Dhul-Hijjah today? Today is Dhul-Hijjah, what? Today is the 6th of Dhul-Hijjah. Today is the 6th of Dhul-Hijjah. Because on Sunday morning, the Hujjaj will be going towards Mina, which is on the 8th of Dhul-Hijjah. And Monday will be 9th of Dhul-Hijjah, which is Yom Arafah. And Tuesday is the day of Eid. Allah Ta'ala says that in the Quran, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ. And Allah takes oath by Fajr, the time, the break of the day, وَالْفَجْرِ, and the 10 nights. And Jumuah, Sahaba and Jumuah, consensus of Sahaba and consensus of the ulama is that these are the 10 nights of Dhul-Hijjah. One should do some ibadat in every night. If you can't stay awake the whole night, but we should do ibadah part of the night, or wake up for tahajjud, or before we go to sleep, make two or four rakats, and then go to sleep. Because the ibadat on this night is like, it will be equivalent to the thawab of the night of Laylatul Qadr, but it's not Laylatul Qadr. Obviously, Laylatul Qadr is mentioned in the Quran as a night where 1,000 months a person gets rewarded. But these nights, if we make an effort in the 9 nights or 10 nights of Dhul-Hijjah, inshallah, Allah will reward us. These nights will pass by. Already 6 nights have passed by. If we did some ibadah, we should be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we didn't do any ibadah, then we should have in our heart grief and sadness that we didn't do. But there is still some nights left that we can make up for the nights that we didn't do. Especially, most of us generally don't work on a weekend. So we should try to take out some time during the night, tonight, tomorrow night, Sunday night, and make ibadat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we didn't fast for all the days that have passed, we should at least try to fast on the 9th of Dhul-Hijjah. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that the person who fasts on the day of Arafah, Allah forgives all his sins for the previous year, and Allah forgives his sins for the coming year. His sagair, inshallah, will be forgiven. See, the difference between other religions and deen of Islam is, the deen and Islam, if you do certain deeds, Allah forgives your sins. But in other religions, until you don't get baptized in some, no sin is removed. And if you don't get baptized, then when you go from this world according to them, then you go into hellfire. But in deen, if a person all his life he was in kufr, and the last moment before he dies, a few hours before he dies, before the spasms of death come to him, he says, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. Allah will forgive all his sins. That's the beauty of this deen. He will not pray one single prayer. He might not do, obviously he's not going to have a chance to do Hajj. He might not even be able to give zakat. If it's not Ramadan, how is he going to fast? But if he says, La ilaha illallah, he enters into Jannah. All his life he did kufr, but at the end he said, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. Now who are we to judge that he said it out of fear or out of genuine concern or he understood deen? Once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sent a group of Sahaba, amongst them was Usama ibn Zayd. Usama ibn Zayd, when we hear the name Usama, we all become a little frightened. We should. Because Usama means lion. Not only does it mean lion in Arabic, it means lion in Japanese also. So Usama ibn Zayd radiallahu anhu, he's Hibbe Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he is the beloved of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Zayd was his father, Zayd bin Haritha. The only man from the Sahaba, from the companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, mentioned in the Quran. فَلَمَّا قَضَى زَيْدٌ مِنْهَا وَطَلًا زَوَّجْنَا. He's the only person named by name in the Quran. And Zayd, Islam, is very interesting. And when Zayd was a child, he was captured and he was brought to Makkah and he was sold in slavery. So Sayyidina Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, her cousin, he purchased him and he gifted him to Khadija. So when he gifted him to Khadija, Khadija then gave him the service of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, slavery in Islam was a very different concept to slavery in the West. Generally, people think, yes, slavery is not a good thing. But in Islam, slavery was dissolved by certain sins if they were done. The only expiation for that person was to be a slave. وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ أَن يَقْتُلَ مُؤْمِنًا إِلَّا خَطَأً. That if somebody killed a Muslim killed a Muslim, then the expiation of his sin was that he had to free a Mu'min slave. If he took an oath and he lied, then he had to free a slave, regardless if the slave is Muslim or non-Muslim. If he did zihar with his wife, he has to free a slave, and so on. So slavery in Islam and slavery in the West was a very different concept. Bayaan was a slave. So when he came into slavery, he was sold, and then he was passed on to Rasulullah. Rasulullah did not treat him as a bondsman like people generally would treat their slaves. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would treat him with kindness. So much so that Zaid's father, Haritha, came looking for him. He found out that he's in Makkah and he's been in the clan of Quraysh, tribe of Quraysh, in the clan of Banu Hashim. And the best man in Banu Hashim, the best man in Arabs, he has him. So he came. So he met Zaid. So he asked Zaid, do you want to come home? So Zaid said, talk to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was approached by Zaid's father. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if Zaid wants to go with his own free will, I don't want no compensation for him, you can take him. So his father told Zaid, be ready. Zaid said, I'm not going to go with you. I'm going to stay with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So his father and uncle asked him that you would rather stay in slavery than be a free man. He said, if it was I was anybody else's slave, I would have stayed free. I would have took the chance for freedom. But this man is no ordinary man. Father, I will never have somebody after him like him. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam freed Zaid and he called him that from today Zaid's name is Zaid bin Muhammad. And he was known as Zaid bin Muhammad until the ayat came, مَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدٌ أَبَا أَحَدٍ مِنْ رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَكِ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave Sayyidina Zaid the highest honor any person can have, that his name, other than the Anbiya, there's only one other person I know in the Quran who's not a Nabi, is Luqman, whose name is mentioned in the Quran. Zaid's name is mentioned in the Quran. Now when Zaid passed away, Zaid was shaheed in Muta. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent his son Usama with a group of Sahaba. They came and they attacked the tribe. There was a war between them. In the fighting, many Muslims were killed. And there was a man who had killed some Muslims. And Zaid overcame him, overpowered him. So when he overpowered him, the man said, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. When he said, La ilaha illallah, Sayyidina Zaid, Sayyidina Usama radiallahu anhu killed him. So the Sahaba argued that you killed a Muslim. So Zaid said, Usama said, that he said, La ilaha illallah, out of fear. Because he knew that Muslims will not kill me if I say La ilaha illallah. So when they came back to Medina, the whole incident was related to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now he was hibbi Rasulullah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to carry Usama when he was a child, a baby, on his shoulders. On one shoulder would be Hassan and one shoulder would be Usama. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to love Usama very much. Zaid was a very handsome white person, but Usama was a black. He was dark, because Usama's mother was Umme Ayman. Umme Ayman was a lady who brought Rasulullah from Medina to Makkah when his mother passed away. She was his freed bondwoman. So Sayyidina Usama radiallahu ta'ala, he told Rasulullah that he had killed so and so and so and so. So when he came in front of me, when I attacked him, he said, La ilaha illallah. So I killed him. Rasulullah says, you killed a man who said, La ilaha illallah. Usama said, Ya Rasulullah, he said it out of fear. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Hal shaqqaqta qalbah. He said, did you tear open his heart and see inside? Usama repeated the same words. Ya Rasulullah, he said this out of fear. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Hal shaqqaqta qalbah. Did you tear inside his heart and see? And he kept repeating this. And Usama says, when Rasulullah kept repeating it, I wish that that day I had just come into Islam, or the ground had opened for me and split. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was trying to emphasize to Sayyidina Usama that when a person says La ilaha illallah, dimaguhu haram, maluhu haram, everything becomes haram upon the Muslim against this person. No matter how many he killed, no matter how many he maimed, no matter what he did before Islam, once he says La ilaha illallah, he's a free man. Meaning that Allah forgives him for everything. Yesterday I was reading a hadith. Very interesting hadith. You must have heard it many times. When a man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he said to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam that in Jahiliyyah we used to worship stones and we used to worship other things and we used to kill our children. They do it today also. They kill their children. But how do they do it? With technology. And we call those people barbaric, but the West calls itself civilized. And if you are not civilized, then you have to understand that they say that you're killing. When they do abortions, that's also killing. But the Arabs and the Jahiliyyah, the Mushrikeen, they used to actually kill them physically before, after they were born. Today millions are killed before they are born. That's the difference. So Usama radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he said this, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, Al-shaqqaqta qalbah. So this man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya Rasulullah, I killed my daughter. And he related the whole story to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you go to Makkah, may Allah take us all. Say Ameen. Don't worry. Don't worry about the money. Allah will take us inshallah. Say Ameen. Tomorrow is Mina starts on Sunday. Hajj is on Monday. So if we make dua today, maybe Allah will take us next year to Hajj. Who knows? Say Ameen. MashaAllah, now the Ameen came out quite loud. If you go to Makkah, may Allah take us all. They've removed everything from the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, except for the Kaaba. Otherwise, if you see everything around, nothing of this existed in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All these huge hotels and all that, nothing. But there's one small place, piece of land, which they still have. It's still there even today. They don't build anything on it. They don't allow anything there. And if you walk from Haram, it's about 400-500 meters from the Haram, from the King Abdulaziz gate. It's a small walled area, and it's just a piece of desert land. You ask them, you've cut mountains, they cut Jabal-e-Umar. There's a mountain called Jabal-e-Umar in Makkah. They cut Jabal-e-Ubais. Jabal-e-Ubais is right in front of the Kaaba where the so-called Malik has his palace. They've cut these mountains. But this piece of land, they have not touched it. This piece of land has little graves in it, baby size. They've kept it to let the Arabs know that this is what we were. Before Islam, before Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this was what we were. We used to bury our daughters alive. That's what they did. So they've kept that. وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةُ سُوِلَ بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَ. So, companion of Rasulullah ﷺ, he related the story to Rasulullah ﷺ. When he was relating it, Rasulullah ﷺ was crying. So somebody else said to Rasulullah ﷺ that حَزَّنْتَكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. He has made you grieve, made you sad. Rasulullah ﷺ said, be quiet, let him say what he has to say. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told him to repeat. When he repeated, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was crying so much that his beard Mubarak was completely full of tears. Then Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to him, O person, Allah Ta'ala, when you say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, Allah forgives all the previous sins, including this sin that you did, that you killed your daughter with your So when a person comes to Islam, no matter what sin he did, Allah Ta'ala will forgive him. So if a person comes into Islam 10 minutes before Salah and then dies after 10 minutes after Salah or during Salah, he will go straight to Jannah. And we who have been born Muslim all our life, Allah will ask us. Allah will ask us. You know why I said all this for? Because when I came to the masjid, three people came in. You see, we live in America, but we still haven't changed. We all have. Most of us have blue passports, American passports. But inside we have not changed. We still have the same Desi and Arab mentality. Nobody comes before 2 o'clock. Because everybody thinks that if I come before 2 o'clock, I might get a bill. Or I might get a summons. Why are you here early for? Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says the first person who comes for Jumuah and enters the masjid for Jumuah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him the ajr for sacrificing a one camel. And the sacrifice is accepted. The second person who comes, Allah gives him the ajr of sacrificing a cow. This is free of charge. You don't have to pay for this. You don't need to go to the slaughterhouse. You don't need to get dirty. You don't need to get bloody. You will get this ajr if you come first and second. And then the third person will get the ajr of a goat or a sheep. And then a chicken. And then an egg. And then nothing. So what I'm trying to say is that there are two brothers here who came before all of us. And they accepted Islam some years back. Alhamdulillah. I'm trying to tell us something. Tell us born Muslims something. That who has more qadr for deen, you and I, or those who came to Islam? Because they left everything. They left their families. They left their loved ones. Some of them have loved ones who are not in Islam. They gave all this up. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. And what have we given up? Nothing. Nothing. Yeah, we come for Jumuah. We come for Jumuah. But it's out of habit. Because maybe the wife nags at us. That, hey, why are you going to go for Jumuah? It happens to me also, don't worry. My wife tells me, come on, get out. It's 1:30. What are you doing here? Or she tells me, hey, when are you going to go for your shower? Jumuah's coming up. So either our wives nag at us, or we have to meet some friends here maybe. Is this why we come for Jumuah? Well, Allah will accept our Jumuah, inshallah. But look at the difference. What we come for Jumuah and what we should come for Jumuah. If 5 minutes late, the speech, then everybody's phone start ringing. Malakul Maut will come. He won't care if we have to go for a job, or if we're going to get married, or if we need to go for an interview. He doesn't care. He will be there precisely on time. Precisely on time. So my dear brothers, on Eid day, inshallah, Salatul Eid is at 7:15 a.m. Not p.m. It's at 7:15 a.m. Tuesday morning. We will start Salatul Eid precisely on time. There will be no Cuban time, no Indian, Pakistani, Bangladeshi time. It will be American time. We have to learn this. And when we come to the house of Allah, we should come ready. So my dear brothers, Allah Ta'ala has given us Iman. As I mentioned a little story, then I'll go ahead. And my brother and they went to Germany about 20-25 years ago. So he told me a story. He said, we went out, they went in Khuruj, in Tabligh. So they were visiting some Muslim brothers in this, somewhere in Berlin or somewhere. So he said, we met an old man, a German old man. He looked at us and said, where are you from? And he said, we're from England. So he looked at them, shalwar, kameez, this, that. He said, you're not from England. He said, no, we are from England. He said, what are you doing here? So they explained to him that they come to see Muslim brothers and remind themselves and the Muslims that we have to go to the masjid and this and that. So they said, he said to them, can I come with you to the masjid? So my brother said, he said, okay, come to the masjid, we take him to the masjid. This was at Zuhr time. In Europe, in the summer, the day is very long. Maghrib happens around about 9:30 in the evening. Isha happens at 12 o'clock in some place. So my brother said, after he came with us, he watched us pray and then we gave him food and that. He sat with us for about an hour and then he said, I want to accept Islam. Old man, about 80. My brother said, you know, when if you want to accept Islam, then you have to take a ghusl, take a shower and that. So there was a shower in the masjid. He said, no, but they said you have to change your clothes. So he said, I want to wear a pair of clothes like you. They said, okay. One of the brothers was about his size, so they gave him a shalwar kameez. He went in the shower, he took a shower. After the shower, they gave him shahadat. He took shahadat. He stayed with them till Asr. In Asr Salah, in the first rakah, he went into Sajda. He was perfectly okay. When he did his first Sajda, he didn't get up for the second Sajda. He went to Allah. All his life he did kufr. But Allah wanted to give him hidayah, Allah took him. He went straight to Jannah. He didn't do a single salah. Even the asr salah he didn't complete. He didn't do hajj. He didn't give zakat. He didn't do nothing that we do. Yet he went straight to Jannah, inshallah. That's what Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to Usama radiallahu anhu. Allah shakkatta qalbah. Did you tear open his heart and see? So my dear brothers, we should be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah has given us Iman. And these days, these last 10 days, the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, today is what date? I know you know because you heard me. What is the date today of Dhul-Hijjah? It's six. Count it. When is Eid? Tuesday. So Tuesday is what? Of Dhul-Hijjah. 10, mashallah. Some people do know that Dhul-Hijjah 10 is Eid. So it's 4 days before Eid. So my dear brothers, we don't even know how many days is before Eid. Because we're so engrossed in our dunya, that we don't know nothing about our deen. And some of you are getting angry that why does he keep reminding us this? We didn't come here to listen about this. We want to do salah and go. But if you come here and you don't learn nothing about deen in half an hour, in the whole week, then I think I haven't done my job. Because somebody, inshallah, will learn something of deen. And we all need deen. Because when we die, none of our wealth comes with us. None of our children come with us. The only thing that will come with us is our deeds. I know it's hard to understand this, or it's hard to contemplate this, but we should go to janazas regularly. When you go in the person's janazah, and when they say Allahu Akbar, how long does it take to do a janazah of a Muslim? Maximum 2 minutes. Maximum. Most of us don't know what to pray in janazah. So every time the imam has to remind us that after the first takbir you have to do Surah Fatiha wa Salah. After the second takbir you have to do Salat al Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. After the third takbir you have to do dua. If you don't know the dua, don't worry brother, just say Allahumma akfir. If you don't know Allahumma akfir, just keep quiet. So for the last 50 years we've been going to janazah, we keep quiet. We don't want to learn. Then one day our janazah will be done. So 90% of the people will not know how to read, how to pray maghfirah dua. So Allah will tell us that 10% did maghfirah dua for you, 90 didn't. So I'll go by the American way, democratic way. Then after the hukm ul kul, so I'll no maghfirah for you, go. Would we like that? Allah won't do that with us. If Allah did, would we like that? So brothers, learn the dua for janazah. For if you don't learn the dua for your janazah, people will not pray dua in your janazah. Some of the things I say might sound bitter, but it's sweet. So my dear brothers, Arafah is coming on Monday. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the person who fasts on the day of Arafah, 9th of Dhul-Hijjah, the day of Arafah, Allah will forgive his sins for the previous year and the coming year. So if we do get a chance, we should try to make at least one fast. We got a few more nights left. Especially this is a weekend night. Make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Make 2 rak'ah. Ask Allah to forgive us. Ask Allah to remove this COVID from us. I know some of you brothers are not wearing a mask. I please request you to take a mask from there and wear it. Why? Because COVID has increased in Florida in the last 2 weeks 400%. If you don't know this, Florida COVID has increased by 400%. Even if we took 2 shots, there's a chance we can still be in hospital. I know some people who are in hospital, Muslim families, who are in hospital, even though they had all the shots, everything. But this is from Allah. So we have to take our precaution. So I advise everybody that when you come to the masjid, please wear a mask. If you don't have a mask, we have masks on the table. It's free of charge. You can throw it away after you go out of the masjid. It's up to you. But when you come to Salah, please wear a mask. Then there's another box. Brothers, get a box.
In the boxes. In the armory.
This is very necessary. Because we could be carriers and nothing happens to us, but we might give it to somebody who could be affected. So this is necessary that we take precautions. Even our children. وَالْقَدْرُ بِاللَّهِ Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he went to Sham in the town of Amwas, but he didn't enter into Sham. So Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah said, أَتَفِرُّ مِنْ قَدْرِ اللَّهِ That, oh Umar, you're running from the qadr of Allah. So Umar said, أَفِرُّ مِنْ قَدْرِ اللَّهِ إِلَىٰ قَدْرِ اللَّهِ I run from the qadr of Allah towards the qadr of Allah. And if you are in a place where, brother, please take a mask with you. There's one mask over there. He says, I run from the qadr of Allah to the qadr of Allah. Yes, if we get affected, this is from Allah also. And if we are not affected, this is from Allah also. So brothers, when you come for Eid Salah, inshallah, hopefully we'll do it outside. But if by chance it's raining and it's wet, then you have to do it inside. Again, please bring a mask with you. We are not doing social distancing, but that doesn't mean that we are all safe. If the time comes and we have to do social distancing again, we might have to. Let's hope and pray to Allah that we don't have to. And that is that we make the prayer on the day of Arafah. Whatever prayer you make on the day of Arafah, Allah Ta'ala accepts it. And Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his main dua on the day of Arafah was, La ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu. لَهُ الْمُلْكُ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ يَدِهِكَ الْخَيْرُ وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ If you don't know any other dua, Allahumma qfir, Allahumma rahim. Brothers, those who go to Hajj, when they make dua in Arafah, it is for everybody. So inshallah, we make dua here. Once we hear, we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers who are coming in, please wear a mask. There's a mask on the table. My half khutbah is about mask. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give me tawfiq also and you tawfiq also, inshallah. As I mentioned, that Eid Salah here in the masjid will be at 7:15 sharp. We only have one Eid Salah. We don't have two or three. We only have one Eid Salah. So 7:15 will be Eid Salah here. And that will be American time, inshallah. Not Desi time, not Cuban time. American time, 7:15. Please pass the boxes, inshallah. Mahmoud, give the brother a mask. Jazakumullah for all you brothers, mashallah. If you still want to do a qurbani in India, we still have one more day. Alhamdulillah, most of our all the people who gave Qurbani money, their animals have been purchased. But they have told me that if you still want to do Qurbani, you still have some more time. And preferable if we do it here in the country. At least a small lamb or a goat, 1 year old goat, a lamb should be 6 months old, not less than 6 months. And one should try to do it with one's own hand. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي أفاض علينا شعابيب نعمه وأمطر علينا من جزيل بركاته وفضل هذه الأمة بأيام الفضل والإحترام نحمده حمدا يملأ الأرضين والسماوات وما وراء الكائنات حكيم عليم سونا في بطون الأمهات وخلق الأرض وسيرها سبع طبقات ثم استوى إلى السماوات تصورهن سبع سماوات ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله الذي بعث بالحجج الواضحات والآيات البينات فمن أطاعه ولازم سنته فاض بالدرجات أما بعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحج أشهر معلومات فمن فرض فيهن الحج فلا رفث ولا فسوق ولا جدال في الحج وقال تعالى ثم أفيضوا من حيث أفاض الناس وقال تعالى والفجر وليال عشر وقال تعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا أعطيناك الكوثر فصل لربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيهن أحب إلى الله من هذه الأيام العشر فقولوا يا رسول الله ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله ثم لم يرجع من ذلك بشيء وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من يوم أكثر من أن يعطف الله فيه عبدا من النار من يوم عرفة وإنه ليدنو ثم يباهي بهم الملائكة فيقول ما أراد هؤلاء وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام خير الدعاء دعاء يوم عرفة وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام الصيام من يوم عرفة يكفر السنة الماضية والسنة القابلة وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام في دعائه أكثر من دعائه يوم عرفة لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ليشهد منافع لهم ويذكر اسم الله في أيام معلومات على ما رزقهم من بهيمة الأنعام فكلوا منها وأطعموا البائس الفقير وقال تعالى لن ينال الله لحومها ولا دماؤها ولكن يناله التقوى منكم كذلك سخرها لكم لتكبروا الله على ما هداكم وبشر المحسنين بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم استغفر الله لي ولكم لسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه انه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد ان سيدنا مولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله اما بعد إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وسيد المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم الأموات وبارك على محمد وأزواجه وذريته. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر وأصدقهم حياء عثمان وأقضاهم علي وفاطمة سيدة النساء أهل الجنة والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله. الله الله في أصحابي لا تتخذهم غرضا من بعدي فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم ومن أبغضهم فببغضي أبغضهم وخير قرني قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم ارحم الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، اللهم اجعلنا منهم، اللهم تقبل منا، اللهم تقبل من المسلمين الحج المبرور، اللهم تقبل منهم. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي. Straighten the lines. Please fill in the gaps. Do not leave any gaps.
الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. وأذن في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجالا وعلى كل ضامر يأتين من كل فج عميق، ليشهدوا منافع لهم ويذكروا اسم الله في أيام معلومات على ما رزقهم من بهيمة الأنعام، فكلوا منها وأطعموا البائس الفقير. ثم ليقضوا طفتهم وليوفوا نذورهم وليطوفوا بالبيت العتيق، ذلك ومن يعظم حرمات الله فهو خير له عند ربه. وأحلت لكم الأنعام إلا ما يتلى عليكم، إلا ما يتلى عليكم، فاجتنبوا الرجس من الأوثان واجتنبوا قول الزور. حنفاء لله غير مشركين به، ومن يشرك بالله فكأنما خر من السماء فتخطفه الطير أو تهوي به الريح في مكان سحيق، ذلك ومن يعظم شعائر الله فإنها من تقوى القلوب. لكم فيها منافع إلى أجل مسمى ثم محلها إلى البيت العتيق. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
ولكل كل أمة جعلنا منسكا ليذكروا اسم الله على ما رزقهم من بهيمة الأنعام فإلهكم إله واحد فله أسلموا وبشر المخبتين الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم والصابرين على ما أصابهم والمقيم الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والبدن جعلناها لكم من شعائر الله لكم فيها خير فاذكروا اسم الله عليها صواف فإذا وجبت جنوبها فكلوا منها وأطعموا القانع والمعتر كذلك سخرناها لكم لعلكم تشكرون لن ينال الله لحومها ولا دماؤها ولكن يناله التقوى منكم كذلك سخرها لكم لتكبروا الله على ما هداكم وبشر المحسنين إن الله يدافع عن الذين آمنوا إن الله لا يحب كل خوان كفور